I'm Carly McAvoy, and today we're talking about decimals. This is just a brief review of some concepts. For more in-depth decimal review, you should check into the videos that have to do with basic math. So what we're looking at first is changing a decimal into a fraction and vice versa. If you have a decimal and you want to change it into a fraction, you're interested in how many decimal places there are. So in the first example, I have 0.2 or 2/10. And so there's one decimal place. So I'm going to put the number 2 on the top, and then the number of decimal places corresponds directly to the number of zeros in my power of 10 number, either 10, 100, 1,000, or so forth. So one decimal place, 1 0. And then, of course, you always want to reduce to lowest terms. So 2/10, if you divide both the top and the bottom by 2, you would get 1/5. So 2/10 is 1/5 as a fraction when in lowest terms. Now 0.75 has 2 decimal places, so I put the 75 on top, and then because I have 2 decimal places, I have 2 zeros. 100 is another power of 10, in this case 2 zeros, and then 75 out of 100, you know, is 3/4 or 3/4 as a fraction in lowest terms. 1.7, well, the reason I wanted to talk about 1 7/10 is because it has a whole number part and it has a decimal part. The whole number part, 1, it doesn't matter whether you're talking about a decimal or a fraction that follows it, that's still just 1. And then we have 7, and we have 1 decimal place, so 1 7/10. Notice if I read that correctly, 1 7/10, you don't know whether I'm talking about the decimal number or the fraction because they're exactly read the exact same way. Now, if you have a calculator, the TI calculators, you can change decimals into fractions. Do you see the button up here that says PRB? And just above that, kind of hard to see on the video, is a button that says F to D. So if I was to put in 0.2, like we had for our first example, and then I want the button directions F to D, I'm going to hit second function, that's that second button, and then that, and you can see it says F to D, I'm changing fractions into decimals, and I hit enter, and it's going to give me that 1/5 that we got when we did that. So if I want to do that with 0.75, 0.75, second function, the fraction to decimal button, and I can get 3/4 that way. So your calculator can do that for you, and feel free to use the calculator for that function, but understand what the relationship is. That is, the number of decimal places matches the number of zeros there. What if you want to go the other way? You want to change a fraction into a decimal? I just divide the top number, that's the numerator, by the bottom number, that's the denominator. So I'm doing 1 divided by 8. Now, I don't want you to spend a lot of time doing long division like that. You can use your calculator for that and just do 1 divided by 8 and hit enter, and it's going to give you 0.125. So that's how you could do it on the calculator. But also you can do it on paper by taking the top number and dividing by the bottom number, the numerator divided by the denominator. Even if the smaller number's on the bottom, that doesn't matter. We have to change it by dividing the top by the bottom. You can see this 4 goes in here twice, you get 8. You would add the decimal and the 0, and 4 goes into 10. Because this, what's going to happen is you're going to keep going and adding zeros as long as you can. And anyway, you're going to get 2.25 if you divide that out. And you can try that. I'm not here to teach you how to divide right now, but you can do that. And then 9 divided by 4 on your calculator is another way to do that. And you get your 2.25 just by putting that directly in there. What happens when you do 2/3? If you do 2 divided by 3... then you get 0.666666. Notice the last number here is a 7. That's because if you decide to round this, the next number, it would be a 6. So it would always round that last one up to a 7. So we could say that 2/3 is approximately, those little wavy lines means approximately, let's say 0.67. that would be rounded to the nearest hundredth. If I ask you to round to the tenth, it would just be 0.7, because the six would always make whatever your last number is has to be going up to a seven. I could do 667. And of course, you've seen people that just do this, that repeating six, you could just put a bar over it. In that case, you're not rounding it, so you're just leaving it as a six, but it does have a repeating bar after it. Depending on what they ask for an answer, any of those could work. Okay, and then we want to compare decimals. When you're comparing decimals, just forget about the decimal point for a second. The decimal point, it's a little small, so I'll make it a little bigger. The decimal points, if you took those away and you just said, what's bigger, 987 or 983? You could see very easily that 983 is less than 987. Think about, somebody's going to give you money. Which amount do you want? You want the 987. So 987 is greater than 983. The fact that there's a decimal there doesn't really matter. Now, that's easy because they both had three decimals. What happens if they have a different amount of decimals? Like here we have two and then three and then four. Well, the easiest way to do that is to rewrite those so they all have the same number of decimals. So I'm going to rewrite those. I'll use red so it stands out a little bit better. I'm going to do 34, and I'm going to add two zeros. 349, I'm going to add one zero. And then 3,412, 10,000s. I'm not going to add anything because it already had four, and so I have now four decimal places on all of them. Now, forget about the decimal point for a second. Which is the greater number, 3,400, 3,412, or 3,490? Well, the greater number is 3,490. That's the highest amount. So if you were asked to arrange that from greatest to least, 3,490 is the most. Since we didn't have a zero on it when we first saw it, I'll put it back in its original form. What's the second most? Well, 3,412 is bigger than 3,400, right? So the second most is 3,412 10,000ths, and then the least amount we had was 3,400ths. And so that's arranging it from greatest to smallest, and if they ask you from smallest to greatest, you just flip those around. What if you were asked to compare something like this, 0.7 with a repeating, to 7/8? Well, the easiest thing would be to change your 7/8 into a decimal and then see what you get. So we'll do that with using a calculator, 7 divided by 8. And if you know those amounts in your head, because the 8s are kind of famous, maybe you know them, then you're no problem. But I didn't remember it. So 0.875. And I'm going to rewrite this to have three decimal places too, since I know it's a repeating 7. 7, 7, but that last one would have to round up to 8. So it really is as a decimal, 0.778 to 0.875. Obviously, then, this is the greater number. Think about, would you rather have $875 or $778? Well, I'd rather have $875. So $875 is the greater number. When you're comparing, you always put the opening of the to the bigger number, and it always points to the smaller number. And the last thing, I think there's some of these that come up that where you have to simplify using decimals. If you were going to simplify this problem using order of operations, you would do the exponent first, and then you would worry about the division. The exponent here is 3.1 to the second power. You don't have to put parentheses around that. I'm going to, because that's how it appeared. And then I'm going to do x to the second power right here, this button right here, x squared, and then just hit enter. And what that gives me is 9.61. Now I'm dividing by 1,000. And when you divide by a power of 10, and I keep saying powers of 10 because that's like 10 to the first power is 10. 10 to the second power is 100. 10 to the third power is 1,000. 10 to the fourth power is 10,000, and so forth. Those are powers of 10, because if you take 10 to a power, you always get a 1 followed by a certain number of zeros, and the number of zeros corresponds to the power. So when I did 10 to the fourth, I had 4 zeros. 10 to the third, I had 3 zeros. So 1,000 is a power of 10. And there's a nice little shortcut. When you divide by a power of 10, you just move your decimal point to the left, the number of zeros that you have. So I know it's going to be So if I take about 961, here's where my decimal was. I'm going to move it 1, 2, 3 places here, and I'm going to fill in zeros. In other words, this was going to have to go 1, 2, 3 places to the left. And I know 3 because I had 3 zeros. But if you don't remember that and you don't want to do it, take your number 9.61 or 9 61/100 and divide by 1,000. And you'll see I was right. It was 0.00961. When you divide by a power of 10, you just move